Hi, it's Dyke from Groovy Entertainment. Today we got another book on tape to play for you. Today's book is Popples, Pop Goes the Jack in the Box from 1987. So let's get started.
Hi there! We're the rock star Popples. I'm Punkity.
And I'm Punkster.
Today, we've got a positively playful story for you in this Popples read-along book.
So, whenever you hear the chime, it means it's time to turn the page in your storybook.
Get ready now to join all your Popple friends in Pop Goes the Jack in the Box. And remember to turn the page every time you hear the chime.
It was a chilly morning in November, and the nip in the air outside and the sound of the howling autumn wind made Mike and Penny glad to be indoors for a change. For weeks, they had been promising their mother that they would clean up their playroom, and today would be the day. Toys of all shapes and kinds were tossed everywhere. Dolls sat in the corners. Robots stood at attention under the desk. Trucks were parked in the middle of the floor, and crayons covered the floor every place else. This job was not going to be easy, but Penny and Mike both knew that their birthdays weren't far off, and if they got rid of all their old toys, they would get new and better ones for those special days.
There, that about does it,
Mike said, putting one last truck in a big cardboard box.
All of my robots are lined up on a shelf, my crayons are all together in an old coffee can, and my trucks are in this box and going in the closet.
I'm finished too,
Penny said with a big sigh.
This place sure looks different. I can actually see the floor. But what should we do with all those old things?
Penny pointed to a pile of toys in the corner. The corner was stacked high with used coloring books, a train that didn't whistle, a doll with a broken arm, a robot with its head bent to one side, and a jack-in-the-box that didn't pop up and play music anymore. Mike had the answer.
I say we load them up in a big trash bag and throw them all away the next time the truck comes for a trash pickup. Who'd want all these broken toys anyway?
As Mike got up and moved toward the window, he added,
Besides, all I care about now is getting outside and bombing you with snowballs. Look, it's snowing.
Penny and Mike loaded all the toys into a big brown trash bag and set them in the corner. Then, shutting the playroom door behind them, they hurried downstairs to put on their winter coats and boots. Then they ran outside to play in the snow, never dreaming that their bag of toys was on somebody else's mind. In fact, it was on two somebody's minds, the two baby Popples. And they had other plans for Mike and Penny's toys. Cripsy popped from under the desk, while Bibsy rolled out of the closet. Just like curious babies, both headed straight for the bag of toys. Cripsy pulled the old jack-in-the-box from the bag and tried to make it pop out of its box. It didn't pop because the spring was broken. Bibsy turned the crank on the side of the box, but it wouldn't play music either. Still, the smile on the jack-in-the-box's face was bright and happy, and the babies were not about to let Mike and Penny throw away the new friend they had just found. Just then, Punkity popped from behind the door and picked up the jack-in-the-box.
What do we have here?
She asked.
Daddy, coo, coo, coo.
Bibsy gurgled.
Oh, I see.
Punkity said with a nod of understanding.
Looks to me like your new friend needs a little bit of fixing up, and maybe even some new music. And I know just the Popples who can do it.
As if on cue, a bang, bang, bang came from the playroom window. Punkity and the babies looked up to see nine colorful furry faces peeking in. With one click of PC's finger, the window opened, blowing in 9 popples, along with tons of fresh snowflakes.
Did I hear someone mention fixing up?
Putter said, pulling an enormous tool chest from his little green pouch. He removed a wrench and added,
Mr. Fix-It at your service. What seems to be the trouble, Puckety?
It's that old jack-in-the-box, Putter,
Punkety said, pointing to the toy the babies were playing with.
He may be happy and smiling on the outside, but on the inside, he's broken to pieces. So are all those other toys in the corner. It seems a shame to throw them away when there are lots of children who would love to have these toys to play with. He's awfully cute,
Prize giggled.
And just look at how much the babies love to play with him. With a little Popple imagination and work, I'll bet we can make him good as new again,
Punkety said. Then, looking around, she added,
and maybe all of these other toys, too. Then Mike and Penny can give them away to a needy child, instead of giving them to the trash man.
I know I can make these toys good as new, Putter said, but I'll need some help. Are you ready, Popples? Calling all Popples!
Prize was the first to answer Putter's call. She pulled a bright red polka-dotted shirt from her pouch and said,
Here, Putter, let me dress him up in this colorful shirt. And I'll make him a new hat with a big white pom-pom on the end,
Puffball added.
But what about the music? What's a jack-in-the-box without music?
Coming right up,
shouted a voice from inside the closet. Then came the sound of some very happy music.
A little music to pop by, anyone?
Punkster said, popping out of the closet and into the room. Putter picked up the jack-in-the-box and pulled Jack from the box. That pull sent his spring flying across the room and bouncing off the walls and floor.
Somebody stop that thing!
Putter yelled.
I'll get it!
Shouted Potato Chip. And with one hop off the floor, onto the desk and into the air, she landed on top of the spring and began bouncing around the room on it.
Yummy! I can't stop this spring!
Potato Chip cried.
Somebody help me!
Potato Chip, 6 of the other Popples formed a pyramid. PC, Party, and Pancake were on the bottom. Prize and Puzzle were in the middle, and Pretty Bit was on top.
Okay, Pretty Bit,
PC yelled from the bottom to the top.
When Potato Chip flies by, you grab her.
Here she comes,
shouted Pretty Bit, leaping from the top of the pyramid and grabbing Potato Chip by the tail. This caused all the other Popples to topple.
Come on, you Popples. This is not the time to pop around,
PC announced.
Punkety is right. Let's fix up this toy before Mike and Penny get back, and maybe they'll help us fix the others.
The Popples busied themselves by putting the zing back in the jack-in-the-box's spring. While Putter pulled and pushed the shape back into the spring, Puzzle pulled a palette of paint from his pouch and painted the outside of the box in bright pinks, reds, greens, and yellows. Punkety and Punkster put together a whole new recording of bouncy, happy music. PC fixed the crank on the side so it would pop open at just the right time, while Prize and Puffball dressed the jack-in-the-box in a brand new red polka-dotted outfit topped off with the perfect pom-pom hat. Putter made the last-minute adjustments.
Just one more little flip of the big switch. Now one big flip of the little switch. A fine tune here, and some finer tunes there. And voila! Stand back, everyone, and get ready to pop.
Let the babies turn the crank to get them going,
Party suggested.
And let the party begin!
and Bibsy crawled up to the side of the bright, glowing new Jack-in-the-Box. Cribsy looked at Bibsy, and they both gurgled happily. Cribsy grabbed hold of the crank and began turning it. As she turned it, the music played and played and played. "Hey, wait a minute here," Putter said, holding up his hand. "Something's wrong. Jack should have popped a long time ago."
"Try it one more time, Cribsy,"
PC said.
"I'll bet he'll work just dandy this time."
Once again, Cribsy turned the crank on the Jack-in-the-Box, and the music played. And when it was time for Jack to jump out, PC clicked his fingers and pop! Out popped Jack with an ear-to-ear smile and enough confetti for a parade.
"Hooray! We did it!"
Party cheered.
"He's beautiful!"
yelled Prize. "He works again!" hollered Putter, just as the playroom door opened and in walked Mike and Penny. "What's going on in here?" Mike asked. "And what are these toys doing all over the floor? We just cleaned this room."
"It's simple, Mike,"
PC explained.
"The babies found this old Jack-in-the-Box and..."
"Mike, I don't believe it,"
Penny said, pointing to the baby popples.
"You've got to see this for yourself."
Mike went to the corner of the room where Cribsy and Bibsy were playing with the Jack-in-the-Box.
"Where did you get the new toy, babies?"
Mike asked.
"It's not a new toy, Mike,"
Putter explained.
"It's the same old Jack-in-the-Box you and Penny threw in that bag over there. We just fixed it up a little, that's all."
"A little? This is great, Popples,"
Penny said.
"We thought you'd like that idea,"
Putter said.
"Now listen to this one. Instead of throwing away all these good toys that just need a little care, why not fix them up and give them away to the children at the orphanage across town?
I'll bet there are lots of kids who would love to get your old toys,"
Punkity added.
"Especially since they probably don't get any new ones during the year. Why, just look what we did for old Jack here."
Mike picked up the Jack-in-the-Box and showed it to Penny. He carefully turned the crank and listened to the new music. Then he walked over to the bag full of toys and pulled them out one by one.
"You're right, Popples,"
Mike said to his little friends.
"From now on, we share our old toys with others. That's the right thing to do. Now, who's going to stay and help me fix up these other ones?"
"Me! Me! Me! Me!"
shouted all the Popples together.
"Then let's get poppin'!"
And with those good intentions in mind, Mike, Penny, and the Popples spent the rest of the day fixing up every old toy in their playroom.
So that would Popples, Pop Goes the Jack-in-the-Box from 1987. So if you like, subscribe, share, and comment, have a good every day. And our next book will be The Story of Pretenders.